The Bible Story in 16 Seas. After Jesus ascended into heaven, the disciples returned to Jerusalem. They gathered together and spent time praying and waiting. They were waiting for Jesus' promise to send the Holy Spirit to come true. Finally, on the day celebrating a feast called Pentecost, a great sound filled the room like a mighty rushing wind from heaven. Then, small flames like tongues of fire appeared above each person, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit. The Spirit Jesus promised had come, and it gave each of them the ability to speak in other languages. Meanwhile, people from all over the world had come to Jerusalem to celebrate Pentecost. They heard the sound coming from the house and came closer. As they listened, they became confused. Everyone could hear the disciples talking about God's mighty works in his own language. "Aren't these men from Galilee?" they asked each other. "How can they be speaking to us in our own languages?" Most of the people were amazed at what they were hearing and asked how it happened and wondered what it might mean. The coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost marked the beginning of God's plan to reach the whole world with the good news of Jesus. The book of Acts tells us that people from at least 15 different countries were there that day, and 3,000 people believed the good news of the gospel. They were baptized and became part of the very first Christian church. God worked in the hearts of these new believers, and they wanted to learn more about Jesus. They prayed together, listened to the disciples teaching about Jesus, and spent time with each other as believers. These new Christians shared what they had with one another. Some sold their belongings and gave the money to those in need. They gathered at the temple and met in homes to worship God. They ate together and shared their food with glad and kind hearts. Every day, more and more people were saved. These new believers formed the very first local church. Their love for God and love for one another helped the people around them see what a wonderful difference God can make in a person's life. Jesus came to fulfill the promise God made to Abraham hundreds of years before, that he would be a blessing to the nations. With the coming of the Holy Spirit, the promise to reach the nations with the good news of salvation had begun. Isn't it amazing how God's power changed people then and continues to change people today? All of us are born selfish sinners who want to keep what we have for ourselves. Even the youngest of children don't like to share their toys. But God's Spirit works to change our hearts. First, God helps us see how sinful we are. Then, he helps us believe that Jesus died on the cross to take away our sins. When we believe this, we are changed by God's Spirit. Our hearts fill with the joy of being forgiven. When we understand that our real treasure is found in Jesus, we can begin to share what we have and give to the needs of others.
The Bible Story in 16 Seas.